Hi everyone, in this video we discuss about multiple choice questions on the topic fiber to fabric. Question number 1. Fiber is obtained from option A, animals, option B, plants, option C, both A and B, option D, none of these. The answer is option C, both A and B. That means fiber is obtained from both animals and plants. Question number 2. Silk is obtained from option A, llama, option B, yak, option C, sheep, and option D, cocoon. The answer is option D, cocoon. Silk is obtained from cocoon. Question number 3. Which one of the following is a wool yielding animal? Option A, sheep, option B, angora goat, option C, camel, and option D, all of this. The answer is option D, all of this. Sheep, goat, camel, all animals are wool yielding animals. Question number 4. Sheep are option A, herbivores, option B, omnivores, option C, carnivores, and option D, parasite. The answer is option A, herbivores. Herbivores means plant eating animals are herbivores animals. So sheep comes under herbivorous animal. Question number 5. What is the scientific name of mulberry tree? Option A, Magnifera indica, option B, Morus alba, option C, Desmodium gerens, option C, none of this. The answer is option B, Morus alba. Question number 6. What is the food of silkworm? Option A, papaya leaves, option B, mango leaves, option C, mulberry leaves, and option D, neem leaves. The answer is option C, mulberry leaves. Silkworm gets the nutrition from mulberry leaves. The food of silkworm is mulberry leaves. Question number 7. Selective breeding is a process of option A, selecting the offspring with the desired properties, option B, selecting the parents with the desired properties, option C, selecting an area for breeding, option D, selecting fine hair for good quality wool. The answer is option B, selecting the parents with desired properties. How do we select the breeds for breeding process means? First, we have to select the desired properties of parental animal or plants to provide good yield, good quality of the products. Question number 8. The general process that takes place at a sheep shearing shed is option A, removal of fleece, option B, separating hair of different textures, option C, washing of sheep fiber to remove grease, option D, rolling of sheep fiber into yarn. The answer is removal of fleece. The removal of fleece, that process is known as shearing. Question number 9. The rearing of silkworms for obtaining silk is called option A, cocoon, option B, silk, option C, sericulture, and option D, silviculture. The answer is option C, sericulture. So the rearing process of silkworm is called sericulture. Question number 10. Which of the following is not a type of silk? Option A, mulberry silk, option B, tussar silk, option C, moga silk, and option D, moth silk. The answer is option D, moth silk. Question number 11. Silkworms secrete fiber made of option A, fat, option B, cellulose, option C, protein, and option D, nylon. The answer is option C, protein. So silkworms secretes the fiber called as protein. Question number 12. A single yarn is used to make a piece of fabric is option A, gemming, option B, spinning, option C, weaving, and option D, knitting. The answer is option D, knitting. Question number 13. Socks, sweaters, and t-shirts are made of option A, spinning fabrics, option B, knitted fabrics, option C, weaving fabrics, and option D, none of this. The answer is option B, knitted fabric. Question number 14. Man-made fiber is known as option A, natural fiber, option B, synthetic fiber, option C, silver fiber, and option D, all of this. The answer is option B, synthetic fiber. So man-made fibers are called as synthetic fibers and artificial fibers also. Question number 15. Which type of climate need cotton plants? Option A, cold climate. Option B, warm climate. Option C, rainy climate. And option D, none of these. The answer is warm climate. So cotton plants need warm climate for its growth. Thank you.